This video demonstrates how to place level datums to establish a framework for the project. Levels define floor levels of a building or other important datums, like the top of a foundation or the roof plate height. In a section or elevation view, use the Level tool to place a level. By default, as you place a level, an associated plan view is created in the project browser. Clear this option if you are creating a reference level for which no plan views are needed, such as the top of a parapet, which is used only for reference. As you place a level, snaps and guides help align the extents of the datum to existing levels in the project. Click to define each end of the level line. When you change the name of a level, the corresponding views in the project are changed as well. Use controls in the drawing area to change the elevation of the level, or select a level and make changes on the properties palette. By default, when you place elements in a plan view, each element uses the associated level datum as a base constraint. Other level datums in the project can be used to define constraints as well. For example, if you place walls in the lower level plan, the bases of the walls are constrained to the lower level, and the tops are constrained to the roof level. When you place walls in the entry level plan, the bases of the walls are constrained to the entry level datum. Top and bottom constraints establish the position of the wall in 3D space. Because the tops and bottoms of the walls are constrained to a level, when the level is moved, the tops and bottoms of the walls are moved as well. All elements in the project are assigned and constrained to levels in order to establish their positions in 3D space.